Jesus is present with us by the Holy Spirit. We continue in the Big God Project. Did you know that Luke is considered to be the author of both the Gospel of Luke and the Book of Acts? We will take a look at this in the Book of Acts and how the early church was formed by the apostles spreading the good news by the filling of the Holy Spirit. Welcome all who are watching this online worship for April 11th, 2021. This is our second Sunday family service and is brought to you by St. Paul's Presbyterian Church in Burlington, Ontario. I am Pastor Bob Sim. I give you the royal wave, and I have a short story for you. One Sunday morning, a pastor of a small church was invited into the children's Sunday school class to share a lesson. When all of the children were seated and quiet, for sake of an illustration, the pastor began describing a squirrel. He started out by saying, "I am going to describe something, and I want you to raise your hand when you know what it is." The children nodded eagerly. Tim. The pastor continued, "This thing lives in trees, and it eats nuts, and has a long bushy tail." No hands went up. The pastor was shocked. He continued, but to no avail, there were no hands. Finally, one little boy tentatively raised his hand. The pastor breathed a sigh of relief and called on him. And the boy said, "Well, it sounds an awful lot like a squirrel to me, but I know the answer must be Jesus." Today's lesson from Scripture is how the Holy Spirit lives within us. I hope you will stay with us until the end of the service. Give thanks and be blessed so you can be a blessing to others. When we conscientiously make a decision to be a disciple of Jesus, the power of the Holy Spirit flows through us and we learn how to rely on Jesus in every way. The Holy Spirit shows us the new life we find in Jesus. Thank you, thank you, thank you for being you and living for Jesus. Support is always available by calling me at 905-921-5667 or emailing me at stpaulsburlington@gmail.com. Our prayer mail goes out on Mondays and Thursdays if any updates or additions are provided. Men's ministry is on Wednesdays at 9:30 a.m. via Zoom. We are studying the book of 1 Corinthians. The next virtual talk is this Saturday, April 17th, 2021 at 9:30 a.m. and ladies and gents are all welcome. A young man lived a rebellious life, addicted to drugs, experienced homelessness, associated with the wrong people, was implicated and charged with first-degree murder, facing a life sentence, was acquitted as he was innocent. Art Dirtson, one of our former speakers, says about Peter Townsend, "His testimony is one of the most impactful I've personally encountered." Our speaker this Saturday is Peter Townsend. The next meet and greet will be on this Wednesday, April 14th at 7:30 p.m. This will be in the evening. All are welcome. The link will be sent out via email. I got my vaccine over a week ago, and I encourage all of you to get it when it is offered. This pandemic has lasted longer than anyone expected, and we thank those of you who have kept supporting the congregation and its mission in the community. We can accept donations by e-transfer, PAR, or by check. Please contact Ron Gambo at 905-330-2909 or egambo@sympatico.ca for any help in making your donation. God has been helping us in so many ways to see this pandemic through. We still have a ways to go, and God will still be faithful to us and through us to others. Please be safe in all you do. You can find out more information about God's family here at St. Paul's by going to www.stpaulsburlington.ca. We will respond to all comments and questions. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. May you be blessed. Our opening song is Shine, Jesus, Shine. Would you please sing along with Nicholas?
Lord, the light of your love is shining in the midst of the darkness, shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us. Set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light. Lord, I come to your awesome presence, from the shadows into your radiance. By the blood I may enter your brightness. Search me, try me, consume all my darkness. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light. As we gaze on your kingly brightness, so our faces display your likeness, ever changing from glory to glory. Mirrored here, may our lives tell your story. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine. Fill this land with the Father's glory. Blaze, Spirit, blaze. Set our hearts on fire. Flow, river, flow. Flood the nations with grace and mercy. Send forth your word, Lord, and let there be light.
Would you please say this prayer with me? Come, Holy Spirit, come. Fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant that by the same Holy Spirit we may be truly wise and ever enjoy his presence. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. While the game for the Big God Project this week to lead us into the theme is Guess Who? You will see a silhouette and some choices to determine who it is. Some younger ones will recognize some, and some of the older ones will recognize the others. Either way, the game reminds us that we need to recognize the work of the Holy Spirit in our lives. Sometimes we only see the effects of the Spirit, but with time and experience, we come to recognize the Spirit's movement.
after the first Easter, Jesus still wasn't done all he had come to do. For 40 days after he'd risen from the dead, he spoke with his disciples about God's kingdom. He reminded them of his love for them and taught them important lessons. One day, after eating a meal together, the disciples asked Jesus, "Are you going to give us back our land now? Are we going to get our kingdom back from the Romans?" Jesus answered them, "Don't worry about those times and dates. The Father is sending you a special gift called the Holy Spirit, who will come and stay with you all. Then, my mission for you is this: tell all of Jerusalem about me. And in all the lands around us, tell people all the way from one end of the earth to the other who I am, what I have done, how much I love them, and what is yet to come." After Jesus said this, he was taken up to heaven. The disciples stood in awe, watching Jesus leave until he was gone from sight. Then they waited for the gift that he'd promised, and waited and kept waiting. And as they stood there waiting some more, a messenger from God came and said, "Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? Jesus has been taken away, but he will be back in the same way you saw him go. But it's not right now." The apostles returned to Jerusalem and sat waiting as Jesus had instructed them to do. Suddenly, a sound from heaven came, like a strong wind blowing, and it filled the entire house. Then they saw something that looked like a tongue of fire. It separated and rested on each one of them, and they were filled with God's promised gift, the Holy Spirit. Meanwhile, godly people from all across the world heard this sound of the Spirit blowing and gathered together outside to find out what on earth was happening. With the crowd outside, the disciples burst out of the building, filled with the Holy Spirit, sharing the good news of Jesus with all the people who were gathered from all over the world. But the thing is, none of the disciples had ever spoken those languages before. The people were amazed and confused. Didn't all of these men come from the same place? How do they all of a sudden know these different languages? Peter stepped forward, and filled with the Holy Spirit, he shared as Jesus had asked him to share, speaking to the crowd about all Jesus had done and all that was in store for them in him. That day, over 3,000 people believed what they heard about Jesus, put their trust in him, and became his followers too. The Holy Spirit had arrived and changed the disciples. The Holy Spirit now lived in them. The Holy Spirit lives in us.
This week's story is about the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit descended like a flame onto the believers. and they were able to speak to the crowd gathered from many different nations and teach them about Jesus. This story shows us that the Spirit's work is to help us share the good news of Jesus. I wonder what the disciples expected when Jesus said he was sending a Spirit to them. I wonder why the Holy Spirit let the disciples praise God in different languages. I wonder what effect that had on all the people who heard them and spoke those languages. I wonder if we have invited God's Spirit into our lives. You know, these questions help us think about what the Spirit's purpose is in our lives and invites us to think about whether we have invited the Holy Spirit to live inside of us. The question this week is, what language would you want to learn? The connection to the theme and story is that the Spirit gave the believers the ability to speak in many different languages. Imagine if you could suddenly speak another language. The languages listed on the coloring page are French, German, Hindi, Korean, Greek, Mandarin, and Russian. How many did you recognize? Well, I got 5 of them and then figured out the other 2. But you know, with the Holy Spirit, there's never any figuring out. He just knows. Our next song was originally done by Hillsong Church in Australia. It is called Holy Spirit, Rain Down. Would you please sing along with Nicholas?
Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Oh, Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down. Let your power fall, let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down. Holy Spirit, rain. And Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Let your power fall, let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down. No eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind can know what God has in store. So open up heaven, open it wide, over your church and over our lives. Holy Spirit, rain down, rain down. Oh, Comforter and Friend, how we need your touch again. Holy Spirit, rain down, your power fall. Let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down. Let your power fall. Let your voice be heard. Come and change our hearts as we stand on your word. Holy Spirit, rain down.
Did you know that the Holy Spirit is the third person of the Trinity? He is a person, not a force to be acquired. Not like in Star Wars, where the Force is something to be learned and mastered. The Holy Spirit is a person like Jesus and the Father, who draws us to a personal relationship so we can get to know them all very well. We had the opportunity for the past 3 months to see Jesus through Luke's eyes. We heard about God's big plan and saw the way Jesus spoke to those around him, by teaching and healing and building hope and promise. In between the lines, we could see the compassion Jesus had for the poor and how he called people to true righteousness, not the fake righteousness that was practiced by many of the religious leaders and their followers. We see in Philippians chapter 2, verses 6 to 8, who, being in the very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. So if Jesus limited his divine power within him, then how did the power manifest through him to know, to do, to care, to heal, to draw all people to him? Well, do you remember what descended upon him at his baptism? The Holy Spirit descended like a dove, and the power of God was in him and upon him. The Holy Spirit is not something to be used or mastered, but draws people to Jesus. In a moment, we will hear a song sung by Kristen Getty, the lady who also sings In Christ Alone and Friends of the Risen Christ, songs I know many have come to love during our worship times. The music and lyrics are by Keith Getty and Stuart Townsend. It is called Speak, O Lord. The Holy Spirit was with Jesus and now continues Jesus' work by speaking into our lives. It asks that we receive the food of God's holy word, that the truth be planted in us, that we would be shaped into Christ's likeness, that the light of Christ might be seen in our acts of love and deeds of faith. All the Holy Spirit's work. It continues to seek that the Holy Spirit would fulfill in us the purposes of God for the glory of Jesus, that we would be taught obedience and true humility, that the Holy Spirit test our thoughts against the radiance of Jesus' purity, that we would have eyes to see and our faith to rise so that we can grasp the heights of God's plans. And the Holy Spirit came as Jesus promised, so that the church is built and filled with God's glory. As you listen to the song, may the Holy Spirit draw you closer. Let us listen to Speak, O Lord.
Planted see today in our acts of love and our deeds of faith. Speak, O Lord, and fulfill in us all your purposes for your glory. Teach us, Lord, full obedience, holy reverence, true humility. Cause our faith to rise, cause our eyes to see your majestic love and authority, works of power that can never fail. Let the truth prevail over unbelief. And by grace we'll stand on your promises, and by faith we'll walk as you walk with us. Speak, O Lord, till your church is built and the earth is filled with your glory.
As we go through the Acts of the Apostles and see the Holy Spirit coming on Pentecost and the church being formed with the Holy Spirit's power, over the next number of weeks, we will see how the Holy Spirit works as he did with Jesus. Philippians 2, verse 5 says, "Your attitude should be the same as that of Christ Jesus." I was recently watching season 2, episode 1 of the Chosen film series. And I would recommend, if you haven't seen it, to watch season 1 and then start with season 2. It explores very well the disciples and their interaction with Jesus. It shows Jesus' compassion and a fullness that the visual image can do. The scene from the one I watched is set in Sychar in Samaria. It highlights the hatred between the Jews and the Samaritans. It echoes the racial differences that are so prominent in our world today. At one point when Jesus is teaching, one of the disciples remarks, "Look, the Jews and Samaritans are standing together, listening to him." Jesus explains to the disciples why they were there. "We were here to sow seeds of peace for generations to come. If we listen to the Holy Spirit speaking, we too can stand side by side with neighbors of all race, creed, sexuality, poor and rich alike, and allow the Holy Spirit to draw us closer and deeper into being more like Jesus." Remember the joke at the beginning of today's service, the squirrel and the answer? Well, this joke, while corny, is funny for one reason and one reason only. It is relatable. We have been there, haven't we? City and church, or maybe even watching the news and asked the question, why? Why was that said? Why does that happen? And we don't know the answer. And perhaps reluctantly, we answer, Jesus must be the answer, especially when we're in church. What if it was to tell you that you don't have to be reluctant? What if I was to tell you that Jesus is the correct answer in some way, shape, or form to any question? Do you believe me? The Holy Spirit will reveal why Jesus is the answer, if you ask the Holy Spirit to do this for you. You see, discrimination, racism, poverty, all can be answered with Jesus. That is the role of the Holy Spirit, to teach us how and for us to be obedient and humble while acting it out. And God's kingdom will be revealed where all are equal and all are in a unity, just as Jesus taught in Samaria. Do you ever wish that Jesus were still with us in person? Well, he is. But it's through the Holy Spirit. And what is really neat is that the Holy Spirit lives in us. The disciples and those listening to Jesus' teaching did not have the Holy Spirit in them. If we invite the Holy Spirit in, also called by some as the baptism of the Holy Spirit, we will find a world of difference as the Holy Spirit draws us even closer to Jesus. If you have not done so, I would encourage you to go into a quiet place and invite the Holy Spirit to fill you up with his presence and draw you closer to Jesus. He will not fail you. You will not be disappointed, for you will be more like Jesus each day and working for God's glory to fill the earth. Amen. As we bring our offerings to you, Lord, we give back to you from the abundant blessings you have given us. May our gifts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our God. Would you please pray with me this prayer for the offering? Blessing and glory, wisdom and thanksgiving, honor and power and strength, be unto you, our God, forever and ever, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us join together in prayer. Lord Jesus, you were filled with the Holy Spirit on your baptism, and being without sin and being perfect, the full power of the Holy Spirit was available and working within you. You healed the sick, you reached out to the poor, you talked to those who were in grief, you counseled those who needed support, and you did this all because you loved us. But now that you sit at the right hand of the Father, and you had promised to send the Holy Spirit to us as our counselor and our guide, we recognize that you, Holy Spirit, are much more than that. You have the same power that was in Jesus available to us. But we recognize that we're sinners. We recognize that we put up roadblocks, and we recognize that we hold back on allowing you to work fully within us. And because of that, we will probably never recognize the full power of you, Holy Spirit, in us until our resurrection, until the second coming of Christ. So, even with our limitations, you fill us. Even with our reluctance, you use us. Even with our shortness of hope, you fill us with hope. so that all the problems of this world could be solved if we would all come to follow Jesus and to invite you, Holy Spirit, in to represent and to be Jesus to us. No more discrimination, no more racism, no more holding people back because of race or age or gender, but that we would all be equal, not just in your eyes, but in each other's eyes, because that is what your kingdom is like, and that's what you call us to, Lord. So, in these weeks ahead, as we find out more about you, Holy Spirit, would you sanctify us, and would you grow us, and would you make us more like Jesus each and every day? And if there are those who have not accepted for you to come in and to live within them, may they do so today. May they, in the quiet of their rooms, just come to you and say, I need you. Would you fill me up so I can be more like Jesus? In our community of faith, the Holy Spirit is alive and has filled many, many people. And we see that through the prayers that we lift, through the actions of love that we take. We are becoming more and more like Jesus with every passing moment. And we're thankful that we can be of help to others. Lord, we first of all want to pray for Cheryl G in the loss of her former husband and for her sons Daniel and Carmelo and their families. We also want to pray for Barb T in the loss of her son and for his family. We extend our condolences to the royal family in the loss of Prince Philip as well. And may you be present in their grief. May your tears mingle with their tears. And in every way, may they know of your support and your presence with them. Lord, there are also those that we hear of that because of this lockdown, that tests and operations are being canceled, and it makes them wonder what the future lies for them. Let them know that you are with them and that they're not alone. And that if there's any way that we can support any of the people on our prayer wall or in our prayer mail, that you would let us know so that we can take the actions of love that you have placed within us. You know, Lord, this has been a topsy-turvy 12 to 15 months, and people are really getting tired of it. But it's always darkest before the dawn. And we know that with these vaccines and with other ways that we will be able to see this through. And just as you have been faithful through all these months, we know that you will still be faithful. And we just need to turn to you and seek you and be with you to know that things will work out. So we come today in thanksgiving, in gratitude for all that you have done, for you, Holy Spirit, that has enriched our lives and has empowered the church to be a community of faith, living with the power of the Holy Spirit to be able to reach out to others and to help others. May we continue to seek you and to do that, Holy Spirit. So, Jesus, we know that you are with us. We know that you abound in love around us. And whether we're doing online learning from school, or whether we're doing Zoom meetings with doctors, or if we're accepting other people picking up groceries for us, or us going out picking up groceries for them. We pray that in all these things that we will be safe, and that in all ways we may give you the honor, the glory, and to let you know that it's such a privilege to be a part of your community of faith here at St. Paul's, and to serve and follow you, Jesus. Thanks be to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And as believers and friends of Jesus, let us pray these words that Jesus himself has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our closing praise song is Spirit of Gentleness. Would you please sing along with Nicholas?
Called once again when you
The power of Jesus is in this world by the Holy Spirit. We can have the power living within us if we but ask. Don't wait. Let the Holy Spirit draw you closer to Jesus today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, and amen.